Pissing Cock Show,
and starring me, Josh Cox, and my buddy, Carlo. And we are hilarious. If you're into OC, our stuff.
Yep.
And guess what that is? What? We are talking about.
Let's
lock out the windows.
Yep.
I'll bring the flag down.
Sounds good. Pissing Cock Show, week 18.
Man,
week 18, I'm so excited.
All cracky on that one.
No, I'm like so hopped up on caffeine right now. Thursday around 12:30 right now that we're filming. I got up yesterday, Wednesday at about 3:30.
I stand by my crackhead reference.
Oh boy, yeah.
I bet your house is really clean.
I cleaned my shower this morning.
Yeah, I bet you did. So at like fucking 5. Probably to some speed metal.
Exactly. Yeah. So anyway.
Easy there.
Week 18. Is that what I said? Week 18? Yeah.
Yeah.
Week 18. Good. It's the Pis N Cox Show.
Yeah. In 10 minutes, you're just... Are we almost done?
Exactly. It's a community question. Now I want to go home and sleep so bad.
Stop.
Collaborate and listen. Yeah. Yeah.
Cox is back with a brand new invention.
Oh!
Perfect segue. Starbucks should start selling intravenous coffee shots.
Okay.
And
here comes. Wait for it. What are they going to call it?
Buckshot.
That's very
You're
good.
Wearing the outfit to really be into some buckshot. To
yeah.
Like, oh, I'm going to go get some buckshot. And then you just, duh, mainline, and you're good to go. When was the baby, when did we conceive our baby? Would that be the protein shake video that we did?
We're going strictly off the weeks of the show. So it's been 18 okay. weeks of the Pis N Cox Show.
So maybe that protein shake video or the protein challenge we did was like the foreplay?
That was us trying.
I'll be right back. I'm going off into the woods. If you hear some crying, just know it's my ritual.
18-week-old baby. How big is it?
A bell pepper.
Awesome. I can picture it.
Yeah.
I cut one up this morning, a bell pepper. Not the baby.
I cut up our baby. Just chopped it right up. Dahmered that shit.
Oh, dude.
What?
You have to go that dark. He, like, ate the babies.
I mean, not babies, though.
No.
Yeah, no, but, he wasn't a monster.
Yes, yeah, he was pretty much a monster. Are you at...
Need some beer.
North Star with it? Oh, yeah. North Star when that dude dislocated his knee right in front of us?
Yeah. You know what?
I never heard a grown man scream
right.
Like that.
The screaming.
Oh, God.
It was the screaming.
He was so loud.
God, he sounded like you when we wake up in the morning and
maybe you shouldn't keep going.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Like, trying to, like... comfort the guy for a second, and we're all like, medic, and like,
why are you touching my wiener?
No, I was just like,
you know what we gotta do though?
Give props to who sent us beer?
Yeah, Aaron Davila.
Formerly known as Legionnaire Mutter.
Yeah, until Facebook got all fucking Stalin.
Broke his shit.
No nickname for you!
Nope. Like,
how are we supposed to know Mike runs barefoot now?
Shoes are on. SC3s all the way.
Speedcox 3s,
mm-hmm. That's what they are.
Go Aaron ahead. Sent us... real, true, down-home
yes.
moonshine. In his words, the kind that the feds don't know about. Earmuffs, NSA.
Still doing banjos.
You should open it now.
Now the mood is set.
The mood is set.
Let's hear it.
Go ahead. Just a nice slow open.
Oh, yeah.
Which one of us is gonna squeal like a piggy?
Burt Reynolds.
Burt Reynolds without a mustache. It's a sad day.
Okay, when we're done here, I'm gonna take it home and clean the floor in my kitchen with it.
Hit me. This is the kind of moonshine that a guy named Big Gus,
yeah.
who is always in overalls and is never not coated in oil.
Yes.
Take them foreign cars out here. You hear?
Rice burners. This is my... This is my least favorite Cheersies of all time. Just so you know.
Aaron, we have to do you justice. Oh, it's picking up now.
I'm starting to feel it.
I'm starting to feel it.
I want a nap so bad.
Yeah. Surprise butt sex?
No.
Beer back, fucking moonshine shot. Better thing to do on a Thursday afternoon? And listen to Dueling Banjos as we drink moonshine in my garage. Did you think this is where your life would be?
Natural progression.
My mom's so proud.
Oh.
Cheersies!
Cheersies! Oh, it's my... What is...
That is some shit.
Oh, oh my God. Thanks. Austin, all this is he also sent us some Star Hill Soulshine Belgian style pale ale.
And some Northern Lights India Pale Ale.
Yeah.
So at least he gave us some awesome beer backs to wash down that insanity.
Do you want to try some more? As dumb as it is, do you want to try a little bit more?
All right.
All right.
Dude, whoa, man, Jesus. Yeah. Okay. What? No, take it out. Don't add more. Fuck. You're
practically equal.
You know what this calls for?
Oh! I'm gonna let you go.
You heard him!
Okay!
Oh! Woo! I'm a man! I'm a man!
Don't chase it!
I haven't changed my beer back yet!
And thereby.
My hair fell off. I immediately regret that decision.
Is it time for community questions, then go home?
Our streak is ending. We've made it 18 consecutive weeks.
God damn
consecutive.
It. Consecutive.
We
will
not be filming next week.
I'll be putting something together. I'm trying to get some special guests lined up.
Hopefully so go ahead and take a break.
Working on something. If it works, it's going to be great, but I don't know. We'll see.
I have just way too intense of a work schedule. I'm ending 18th Transformation Challenge. I have to put together all the awards, before and after certificates. I put together a slideshow. There's a huge party that coincides with it. And
23 pounds I lost in that one time I went with you.
Dude. Pretty much takes me the entire week of night and day prep, and something's got to give, and filming and editing this is the thing that I take a week off of.
If I do a show, which I will at some point, it will not be edited whatsoever. It'll be a straight shot, because I don't fucking edit. I don't know.
If
you
put something together and it's awesome,
dude,
fucking fantastic.
Yeah. I'm going for awesome. I mean,
but then if it does suck, it's just going to make people appreciate me so much more. Hey, right? Me!
Yep.
Go ahead, your turn.
I'm gonna try.
No, me.
Yes. Well done.
Yay! More enthusiasm.
We switched beers.
Well, you took mine, so I took yours.
I just want to try.
Yeah, we're Eskimo twins. Since we're on the topic of alcohol, we might as well bring up the fact that
Charles
and Michelle Haupert did probably the coolest fucking thing ever, they made us our own home brews.
I swear to God.
I said it, and I can't remember what week it was, but if I had a beer, it would be called Hoppy Cox. And Charles Haupert, Chuck Hoppy.
C to the hop.
He did that shit.
He did. Piss Drunk Cider. 12.7%. Trying to kill me.
You're two shots of moonshine in, so.
What's your name? It's my attaboy. I'm telling you, it's been like 14, 16, 18, 27 hours since I showered. You don't want to do that.
Thank you, Charles and Michelle Haupert.
Seriously, no, it's really awesome. Guys, that's really nice.
Oh, or the Belgian.
Belgium so bad.
Yeah.
They have a Battle of the Bulge Museum. Don't.
You.
World War II. Why did you say that? And I'm like, because I've had two shots of moonshine and half a beer.
Sorry,
where'd my headband go? Oh, I found it. Did I take this off?
No, you didn't.
What the fuck? Oh, boy.
Beards are dropping like goddamn flies.
And I couldn't be happier about it. Oh, my God.
Hey, can you do me a kindness?
Don't spit on me.
Can you do me a kindness?
Yeah.
Can you eat shit?
Say shut the fuck up. Vanessa, I'm sorry. I just think Chris looks great without the beard. I don't screw him. So, I mean, it's up to her.
God,
I'm just saying, I went to Portland. All those fucking guys had the same. They got the Macklemore.
Well, yeah, that's Portland.
The Macklemore haircut.
Portland literally invented the hipster.
Stop with the flannel and the beards.
The flannel and the beards. Stop being men, everyone. Look at this guy, fucking Metro.
Eddie Vedder wore flannel without having a beard, and that guy's a fucking bajillionaire.
The two don't correlate at all.
May I please have a quick sidebar, really quick? Please don't cut this out. Go ahead, baby. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Supernatural.
Yes.
They ran Tough Mudder Central Texas. Those, what are they called? Those lines, the cum dumpster? The cum ridges?
Cum gutters.
Cum gutters. Yeah, you would know.
I don't want to brag. I actually have those right now.
Prove it.
No.
Prove it. Prove it.
I had a burrito last night.
Dude.
That fills that shit.
I could dunk, but I ran five miles.
I don't have my Hokas on right now. Brad Johnson, fucking Florida State, did everything in that game.
Oh my God. You're going to be the one guy that's like, Brad Johnson get as much recognition as he deserves.
Super Bowl MVP.
Fucking Brad Johnson. Yeah, I don't think so.
Look, I have to have a mohawk out of this shit in a month. I got to make a mohawk out of that. I can't even grab it. Go ahead, try it.
I got it. Ow. I have it.
Never mind.
Yeah, I guess you can grab it. Huh. Mm-hmm. Eat shit. Erik.
Panu.
Congratulations on your first 100K.
Seriously,
holy shit.
That was the Quicksilver,
100
right?
of those Ks.
Jesus.
Yeah, I don't know what it was.
I ran 5 of those recently and was like, that's a lot of Ks. My 5 was faster than his 100, but they should be.
You know what I want to give you? A high five.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Thanks, buddy. I am loaded.
Erik Panu's a eat. Fuck eat.
I love that.
Take his 100K advice and apply it to your drinking. What? Save your bacon.
Can we just do a little something with that? It just keeps bugging me that it.
I know. You know who else it's bugging? No one.
You have a hair tie?
No, I'm not.
Can I just fucking
Oh, it'd be like the pear.
Oh, that's not.
In your butthole. More in your me. Wait, this, just, yeah.
Don't actually.
And now I'm going to open it. That's his butthole.
Okay. All right.
Put your wiener in there.
This is off the fucking rails.
Hey,
this is you.
Rob Greer.
Trainer guy. Go ahead, buddy.
Bosu, man. Working on that ankle stability.
Yeah.
That's going to be your ticket.
Did my friend Aaron message you privately about Bosu work? That's the actual question. Don't put it. No. This is. Oh. Man. I need some bread.
Matty Gregg brought up that they're changing the gamble to the cock blower.
I took credit for something Cassie Harris said today.
Yeah, what is it?
I don't remember.
Guess what Carlo told me? Carlo on his own came down to me and he's like, hey, guess what I figured out with no one's help?
Oh, that's right. What did I figure out?
What did you think I was going to say? We're 6 months away from World's Toughest Mudder. What did you think I was going to say? Hey, Jason, say that.
Holy shitballs.
That's not it.
Holds up full.
I hadn't seen that ebib of Matthew Lowe.
No, neither had I.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, neither had I. Neither have I. Neither had I.
There's nothing better and at the same time worse than a drunk grammar Nazi.
What did Justin Scott want?
Is that all we're going to talk about, the Jason thing?
Yeah, because I don't know that topic, so I don't give a shit. I don't know.
Oh, yeah. So you
don't... No, I have no idea. I'm just going with it, man. I'm going with the flow. I'm fucking zagging when you're zigging. That's a good team mace too.
That calls into question anytime I bring something up and you're like, yeah, that thing. Do you even know what I'm talking about? I don't.
I always know. I always know.
What did the ebib of Matthew Lowe say?
What is that?
At least 10 minutes of exercise will increase your ability or your increase your tendency to post inspirational quotes by 60%. And I don't even have that in front of me. That's just off memory because I care about the community.
I want to see that. I want to see someone quantify that. I don't believe that for a second.
It's proven.
No, it's not. You're making that up.
Scientologists put a report out.
This conversation is going nowhere.
You're going nowhere. You know where it's going?
I'm having trouble focusing.
Nowhere.
I can't.
What's that from?
From Moonshine. That's from.
He ain't going nowhere. He's going fucking nowhere. Where you going? Nowhere.
Do you know how I know that the world's coming to an end?
Because The Rock is in the movie about the world coming to an end?
No.
San Andreas.
That's right.
I saw it on Instagram.
Just Instagram?
Oh, that fucking guy. He's so great. Go ahead. Hold on. Okay. Okay. What are you doing? What are you doing?
Look at yourself.
Why are you doing that? Why are you doing that?
I just want people to see what I see. We're just so drunk.
No, I'm fine. I'm fine, Jesse. My face is really... That bright is so light. Or no. Oh, God. Okay.
I know the world is...
My face hurts.
Matty Craig did a Spartan race.
Holy You're shit. Actually crying. You have actual tears.
I was laughing that hard.
That's a bad idea. Those go over there. Magnus Spartan? I know. He did. I know. Todd Brilliant has a hay bale in his backyard, and I practiced throwing the spear in his backyard. Yeah, I suck.
It's one of those things where it's like, even if you're good at it, you got like a 50-50
yeah,
shot.
Yeah, seriously, right? Like, unless you're an actual Spartan.
What is your profession?
Me personally?
No, that's my...
Oh.
You, there. What is your profession?
I'm a potter, sir.
And you, Arcadian, what is your profession?
Sculptor, sir.
And you?
Blacksmith.
Spartans! What is your profession?
I provide engineering support to a night shift at a manufacturing plant, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, every other Wednesday, and then every morning from 8:05 to 8:35, I'm a yard duty on the playground at the middle school. That's what I do. Those are my jobs.
See, old friend, I brought more soldiers than you did.
Ow!
God damn it.
Brought more soldiers than you did.
Leah!
Oh, God, please.
Hohisel!
Hohisel!
Oh, you should come do world stuff.
Oh my god!
With us.
Why would you not? There's only like 6 women doing it right now. Leah, you've got to do world stuff with us, please, with See? Us, all of us.
I feel a connection.
Seriously, yeah. There's like 6 women doing it. You should be the 7th. Please, please.
Got her.
I just sent this out there.
Yeah, to her specifically.
Yeah.
I would be surprised if her registration isn't in.
She was like typing
right
as. Yeah, yeah, she was like, I'm
right,
in.
That's
go.
All I needed.
Click. $600.
But seriously, what if someone told you, grow a beard and I'll pay for your ticket?
That's not fair. I don't know what I'd do.
Yeah, you think about that.
How long do I have to grow it for?
Because I might even start a fucking GoFundMe. Get Carlo to grow a beard. You would have to grow it until world stuff is mutter.
That would suck so bad.
I'm willing to make shirts for everyone to get myself to World's Toughest Mutter. Are you willing to grow a beard?
I don't know.
Think about it.
I will.
Colin Irvine, you have the best photo.
Oh, my God.
Talk
about it.
If I'm ever feeling like, I don't want to go do that workout, I'm just going to bring up your photo and be like, man up.
Ivan Drago, bleeding from the face, kind of.
Yeah, like.
Although he's Australian, not Russian.
Yeah. He's super smart. He is extremely smart.
He's like, Dolph Lundgren, me. But whatever.
They're getting you in Expendables 4.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
I'm the one driving the smart car. Fucking Sharkbait, off the market.
Corey.
Oh.
Drum right. Off the market. Thought we had something, Corey.
Sharkbait, I thought maybe she's going to go with guys who are twice her age and half her height. Thought I had a shot. Leave that shit in. That's funny. Do it.
I just want to see you get excited.
I just got that excited.
Hey.
No.
If I showed you my boner off of screen.
No.
What?
Justin's not here. That doesn't work.
Yeah, no, we successfully got him to not show it. Hey, I'm going to show it. You ready?
Nope. Go ahead.
It's out.
I'm not looking.
It's out.
I'm not looking.
It's out.
I'm not looking.
If I hold it out long enough, you will. Curiosity will get the best of you.
I promise it won't.
Okay, it's back.
Community questions. Community questions. Mike, no longer Barefoot Mutter Cook, says, why would Facebook make me change my name?
Facebook hates you.
Yeah, and they don't like catfishers.
Because Zuckerberg is personally going, who's this Barefoot asshole?
Chun Zack Lee wants to know if he looks like... I'll be honest, I know zero about Dragon Ball Z.
I know probably just a few more percentages than you do.
Do it.
I can tell you definitely look like fucking Frieza.
That was the Ken Jacobus...
Yeah. National my God. Yeah. Yes, Chun, you do. The eyes look a little squinty. So it sounds like all of the weed helps out with your running.
Oh, yeah.
So
that's right. That was from last week.
You keep that shit up, Chun. That's the answer that you were looking for. All of the weed.
Oh, Heather Kerr. She wanted to know, when selecting cakes for a Tough Mudder event, what's the optimum cake to frosting ratio?
Here's you and I are probably completely different. I can almost guarantee it.
Okay, now here's the thing. First off, I don't want to insult all you I make a cake from scratch people, but just bear with me with the units of measure. I say one box cake equals two containers of frosting. And here's why. You do your box cake, right? You get two layers out of it. You frost that shit. You frost the middle. You put the thing on top. You frost the top on. If you have leftover frosting, you know what you do? You put the frosting on top. And if you still have... room, you cut the cake and you dip it in your frosting container and you just keep eating the frosting.
Here's the thing is what you just described came from the same guy that's like, I'll never have Nutella because it's too high in sugar content. You fucking... described dipping frosted cake in more frosting, yet last week you're like, I don't want to eat Nutella because the sugar content's too high, but I will dip my fucking frosted cake in more frosting.
Have you had...
You hypocritical asshole.
Justin Scott says,
look into it.
Says, do you know any naked obstacle course or otherwise racing events?
I just like that also brought up Mike Cook's question of, will Justin ever learn how to use Google?
That was good.
And let me guess, how did you research?
I binged that shit. Listen, there is something called the Mud, Sweat, and Boobs 5K. I'm not even kidding. June 20th of this year, at the Sugarway Hills Clothing Optional Campground in Burlington, Wisconsin.
Awesome.
They have a Facebook page. You should find it and put it on the screen as I'm saying this. Sugar Hills Clothing Optional Campground, Burlington, Wisconsin. Mud, Sweat, and Boobs 5K, June 20th.
Excellent.
Of this year.
There's also Hulu Plus Quantum Leap Marathon on my couch for the date of... whenever you can make it. Hey, I do want to share the story. Wesley asked what it would take for me to shave off my beard. So I did a segment on The Doctors, the TV show, and it was only like 3 minutes and 40 seconds. The producers of The Doctors, they said, you have way too much hair going on for our cameras to pick up on and actually have it look okay. Could you get a haircut and shave your beard? And I thought about it very briefly and said, no. And then they said, here's the thing, we'd need you to. And I'm like...
They said, well, we gave you an option. We weren't really giving you an option.
Yeah, it wasn't an option.
If you want to be on TV.
Yeah. And so I'm like, well, here's the thing. I want to keep my hair. I'll shave my face. That's the best I can do. And they were like, okay. That's exactly what happened, and I hated it. I had my own Rebel shirts, and then when I got there, they're like, oh, actually, we said you could wear those, but we're not sure about, like, the
fucking
copyrights.
Hollywood.
And I'm like, I made these.
Yeah, they're me.
They're me.
Yeah.
I'm the only one who would get mad if I'm wearing them. And they're like,
I'm infringing upon myself.
Oh, we're not sure, so here's a black shirt instead. So I'm in fucking short shorts and a black
t-shirt. Why has it always got to be a black shirt?
And my nipples were so hard that they had to tape them down because network sensors wouldn't allow the nipple silhouette.
Yep.
I'm really pulling them.
You are
tugging
hard.
Oh.
We recently taped the show. We called it the Doctor's 100,000 Pound Weight Loss Challenge. And we definitely didn't want you to miss out on this next story. He's an extraordinary man who was bullied for years, but he didn't let that stop him from making a big change.
At age 14, Josh Cox weighed 265 pounds. 2 weeks into his freshman year of high school, six teenage bullies surrounded Josh as he walked home from school.
They grabbed me and quickly duct taped my arms and legs against the bleachers so I couldn't go anywhere, and exposed my belly. When they're done, they just gather their bags and walk away.
Embarrassed and ashamed, they devised a plan to put an end to the bullying.
When my mom got home, I asked her to sign me up in the gym.
By the end of his junior year in high school, Josh had lost 60 pounds. He conquered bulimia, and a friend introduced him to bodybuilding. Josh is now inspiring others at Anytime Fitness in Santa Rosa.
1, 2, 3, rebellion!
And Josh is here to prove to us it's not just about weight loss, it's about gaining confidence. Josh, that's a tormenting story.
Yeah. One thing that I always like to remind people of is that everybody's got their own bleacher story. Everybody's got their own either food disorder or lack of motivation. And so I represent not a lot of people that are not my individual successes, but the majority. Everybody's got something that can relate to that, and I use that every single day, because to forget where you come from is to forget what you're doing this for.
Mm-hmm. And you're doing this now as a trainer. You're motivating people to overcome their own demons.
Oh, absolutely.
And can I ask you how much weight you've lost?
I lost 90 pounds total.
And this is where we have to be. I'm gonna modify this number a little bit. Did you guys see how ripped? Put that picture back up. Look at that guy.
Yeah.
Like, you lost a lot of. You're loaded with muscle. And you know what's funny is, you might look at Josh and say, okay, well, he lost 90 pounds. It's not about the number. Mm-hmm. And I think you're living proof of that, because the truth is, you could probably lose more pounds if you got rid of all that muscle.
Yeah, oh yeah, you know, and it's one thing that I always talk to everybody all the time about, don't let that scale control you. That scale's a barometer, but that scale is not the thing that decides who you are.
Is there any other secret that you use with your clients or for yourself?
I heard some people say it earlier, but it's all about perspective. It's all about changing your mindset. You gotta want it more than anything, because anything can stop you. And I hate sounding like a broken record, but until you will give up everything you possibly can to get after everything that you possibly deserve, and you just keep looking for shortcuts, and you keep looking for what's gonna be the next fad diet or the next quick fix, it's your life. Your life is not a quick fix, people. It's not something you try to find the next pill that's gonna get you better, because it's not the pill. It's up here, it's your brain, you gotta start there.
And Josh, you're not a broken record, my friend.
Kevin Chow wants to know, has the Pis N Cox show drawn more entrants to World's Toughest Mudder, or scared them away? Come on, really?
You tell me.
Do we have drawn, Khanh, he wants to know, how many slices of bacon can Pis N Cox consume during the taping of one of our shows?
No, I'm just, all of the bacon. Like a slice or two. No, all fucking one or two slices.
Actually, I really love bacon a lot.
Okay, maybe three slices.
We can take a pound.
You got a delicate stomach.
We can do a pound each. Now, Justin Scott, of course, he always prefaces, this is an important one. Do we cut our classic peanut butter and jelly sandwiches into squares or triangles?
Here's the thing. I don't fucking cut them.
Nope.
I just eat that shit as one big square.
I do a triple layer sandwich. If I'm doing peanut butter and jelly, not almond butter, peanut butter and jelly, I go bread, peanut butter, middle piece of bread, jelly on both sides, and then peanut butter on top of the next piece. Boom, three pieces of bread. And I whole, gone.
How do you cram it in your mouth? What?
Walter Lyon wants to know, if Cassie Harris and Rebecca Crump were our boot camp drill instructors, what would they most likely chew our ass for?
Shorts too short.
Oh, is that what it is?
For me.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I'd be like, what are you doing, ass hanging out? And I'm like, I don't work out hard this hard to not show it off.
They're both really attractive women, so I think I'd be distracted by their attractiveness, and they'd yell at me for not paying attention.
Same thing happens when I'm training them.
Brian Muttee wants to know, Fruit Loops. Oh, this is Fruit Loops or Fruity Pebbles? This is so easy. Don't you fuck it up.
At the same time. Okay. We'll say it together.
Okay.
One, two,
three. Fruity Pebbles.
All right. I was really worried about you for a second.
I was going to punch you. James Bat Dog. How come he has a nickname? How come James Bat Dog Harris still has his nickname?
Here's the obvious answer. That's really his middle name.
Shave or wax in the bikini area. Now, he didn't actually specify if he's talking about us or what our preference is for other people.
Right.
So I'm not going to answer it.
Oh, I'll answer.
Go ahead.
I just want full 70s Amazonian glory whole time. Just shaft my crotch.
I'm here to check the plumbing. Boom, boom, boom. Our buddy Denny, he says we should bring up the socks box socks.
Apparently they have the new design coming out.
Maddie and Denny are working on the new design.
So is it designed yet? Are they available?
I don't
Can
have
we
the
show
answer.
A picture?
Oh. Brian Muttee wants to know who will join him at World's Toughest Mudder by shaving and dyeing their hair in the F cancer lifestyle. Or
Carlo
no,
will.
I won't.
I will do other. Yeah, no, he'll totally do exactly that.
No.
I am going to keep my hair.
I'm actually not,
most likely.
I'm
he's
gonna,
going to, no
I'm,
matter what he says.
I'm not
going to
have a
And then I'll do
world.
Something else different.
No.
But he will.
No.
Yeah, Carlo will.
No.
Carlo totally will.
No.
He was going to.
This was good. This was fun.
Number 18.
Number 18.
In the books. Our streak ends here.
Our bell pepper. Well, don't keep saying that. It's like the show will go on, just not the.
Yeah. But I mean, we went 18 weeks in a row. I'm really proud of that.
I am too.
I am straight 4.5 months straight.
Pis N Cox week 18.
Fuck, so much cheersies.
Cheersies. Cheersies.
Cheersies.
I'm going to go throw up now.
So Carlo and I were such big dum-dums and got so loaded off of moonshine that we completely forgot to welcome all the newcomers. I felt Chicago was in order. I would like to welcome Aiden Harrison, a bricklayer from the UK, hell-bent on taking on his first World's Toughest Mudder. Then I'd also like to welcome Barrett Thompson to the group. He's from Nashville, Tennessee. I'm going to be coming to Nashville in August for Anytime Fitness Conference. Barrett, I hope to see you. Nikitas J. Ballas, chow approved. Paced chow for his fastest lap. Ready to take on the hurricane that is WTM. Alex Soutis, you pitted last year. You're taking it on this year. You're a champion. Champion! Chris Roskin, silver bib bound. Coming back again. You're gonna get it. You're gonna get all of it. Aaron Krebs, met Drake Stumbo in Arizona last year. Did his first World's Toughest, coming again for number two. You're gonna get this business too, buddy. Aaron, Dylan DeHart from Phoenix, Arizona. God, it's so hot out there. It's not just you. Coming back for a second World's Toughest Mudder. Can't wait to do this again with you, buddy. It's gonna be glorious. David and Susie Huck, husband and wife team. Wife is gonna be pitting for David for his first World's Toughest Mudder. Welcome to the crazy. Marla Borst Benson. On Team Black Ops OCR last year. Are you doing a team this year? I don't know. I just know that you're doing it this year, and that's awesome. Just let the sweet sounds of Chicago soothe you, Marla. Kyle Barnett did 50 miles last year, gunning for 60 this year. I'm just gunning for 50 this year, so hopefully you are 10 miles ahead of me and then some, partner.